Hey there, it's Danielle Smith. I'm sure by now you have, if you haven't seen, at least heard about the video that Jennifer Livingston, a television anchor from WKBT in La Crosse, Wisconsin, did in response to an email she had received from a viewer that basically said she was too heavy, used the word obese, and called into question whether or not it was possible for her to be a role model for her community because of her physical appearance. She did this brilliant on-camera response that they ran on their news after that particular email had been shared on their Facebook page. She is married to one of the main anchors, and her husband was very bothered by this email as well. And they received a lot of outpouring, a lot of comments from their community about this type of email. What I wanted to address is how powerful video and that face-to-face communication can be. Jennifer could have just written an email response to this particular viewer. Jennifer could have responded just via Facebook. She could have written an article about it, but there is something so incredibly powerful about her getting on camera and actually sharing this particular experience with viewers. It's powerful not only because she gets to actually say, here's what happened, here's my actual response to it, but the viewer has the opportunity to see how it affects her personally. When I was watching this video, I could see that she was holding herself together. I could see how eloquent she was, how dignified she was. And not only was this about, she didn't only make this issue about her and her weight, but she made it a broader issue in terms of bullying and how hurtful something like this can be when you talk about someone's physical appearance and especially link it to whether or not their outsides can affect the kind of inside person they are. I used to be an anchor and a reporter, and I used to get emails like that all the time that constantly talked about my physical appearance, that I was ugly, that I was too unattractive to be on television, that the camera always adds 10 pounds. And then, of course, there was the physical picking apart, whether or not a certain color looked good on me, whether or not my hairstyle was good, it was too short, it was too long, my nose was too big. There was always something, and that type of thing is very hurtful. Now, in this particular case, it was her weight, and they definitely made that connection to whether or not it was possible for her to be a good role model, which is horrendous. But that opportunity for her to make that connection with the viewer, to look directly in the camera and to say, this is me. And as a viewer watching, I was able to say, wow, she really held it together. Could I have done that? Because as she was speaking, there were sentences that she used that I thought, I mean, I got chills, I'm getting chills now. And I kept thinking, I don't know if I could have held it together as a woman, as a mother, when she said, you know, I have three daughters, and this viewer, this man, questioned whether or not I was even a good role model for girls in particular. And to me, I instantly put myself in her shoes. And I think that is one of the beautiful things about this means of communication, why video is so powerful. The written word is beautiful, and there are people who have moved me to tears with the way they write. But someone like Jennifer can use this particular medium, and she can connect with you very likely even better on camera than she can via the written word. So consider using video as a way to connect with your audience, as Jennifer did in this case, to say, this is who I am, this is what I have to say, because in many cases, it can really get your message across. I would love to know, what do you think, not only about Jennifer's situation, but what do you think about video as a means of communication? I'd love to hear from you. Please comment below, and of course, you can on the post as well. Find me on Twitter, @DanielleSmithTV, and as always, thanks for watching.